Swami Raj of Japan. Before starting, I would like to thank ICSD Club, FDCU for giving me a chance to have my presentation. Today, my topic is possibilities of full digital implantology in my private clinic.
I can tell must contribute IT activity.
my clinical case in IKI online lab. This is Dunga and Belga, and this case my US family. And I post my question and implant dentistry and answer to I remember question in global forum in IKI lab. I post over 400 times since 2012, and I am number one in the world now. If you post your question, I will answer to you. If you are a member, you can see this global forum and question to global forum. My question and answer. This is a picture of IKI annual general meeting in Istanbul, Turkey. I was invited because of my providing a lot of posts in global forum in IKI. You can see the mission of IKI. I want to focus on education and research of IKI. And so based on IKI research and evidence, Stroman developed new implant system. So Stroman system is very reliable for long period since about 1980. We use CAD/CAM system 2000, convincingly since 2008, Stroman guided surgery since 2011. Intraoral scanner, CLOS-3-shape, was launched in Japan in 2016. So we can try full digital implant treatment with Stroman system. This is the movie of digital impression. Digital impression is suitable for implants because figure of implant shoulder is standard type. So perfect impression taking is easy for everyone. You can see this case in detail later. This is Papa's mode. This is complete data workflow in Stroman system. Initial data is gathered with convex CT and intraoral scanner. Treatment plan is performed with core diagnostics software. After surgery, data impression is taken immediately. Preliminary restoration and final restoration is fabricated with Stroman CAD/CAM system in my clinic. Nowadays we use digital workflow in almost case. I need to breathe last year with my staff. You can see the clinical case with missing tooth. 12 and 46 expected extracted teeth. After extraction, digital impression was taken with CLOS-3 scanner for surgical guide fabrication with under 10 minutes. This is CLOS-3 image. This is extracted teeth. You can see the photo about CBCT data gathered from monitor Akitomo 170 made in Japan. This CBCT is most excellent data in the world. This is CBCT data. Diagon data from CBCT and STL data from intraoral scanner were superimposed in Stroman CAD software and designing diagnostics workshop. From its superimposed data, surgical guide was planned with Stroman guide software for diagnostics. Ideal plan where Asokutish and onboarding is a different position. From here and onboarding and Asokutish boarding is a different position. And design surgical bio. The left photo shows from surgical bio and right photo shows fabricated surgical bio set in patient 20. And this is very fit, nice fit in digital drilling bio. And digital drilling bio is fit to dentition very well. Please note the partially rounded incisor line for not separate lingual mucosa. This is incisor line, you see, and not separate lingual mucosa. If inserting cord is over 15 Newton centimeter and ISQ value is over 60, implant stability is very good and immediate impression taking is possible. And please caution not affect implant stability. This is insertion control is over 15 microcentimeter. ISQ value is over 60. Impression taking is possible, I think. Left photo shows scan post was set to implant immediately, and right photo shows intraoral scan data from C-shape L3. And this is campus set photo and curiosity data. This is an SKU data. And dual mandibular photo. And virtual mandibular photo with curiosity. Please note sequence of implant placement. Shape and implant placement while next and buccal superficial augmentation. This is a roll technique. Roll technique was applied to include buccal fundal augmentation. And you can see including the sequence of this case almost 5 minutes moving. And extraction. Number 45. perform. We take this lesson only in plant placement type area only. About 5 to 10 minutes only. After impression, suture. Swedish sister body weight in all muscles. Body weight type restoration is stronger than zirconia abutment. Yellow is variable type of red, square is full zirconia type. This contact between abutment and implant is desirable for metal than zirconia from the point of strength steel. You can see the video of another body weight case. Please note the condition of soft tissue.
Cement inclusion risk, low cost, high aesthetics.
different important as below. Firstly, buffer bone is about over 2 mm. Secondly, distance between implant to margin 3 to 4 mm. It is active 4 mm. And thirdly, subgingival contour, this line to this line, 30 to 45 degree. SGC angle and this angle, this line to this line, 30 to 45 degree is ideal for implant position. Because the list shows the importance of SGC angle. Tooth color for ceramic space is good. Soft tissue stability, blood control, and strength for adequate occlusal force. This is based on not angle. SGC angle is 30.3 degree in this case. So this angle is suitable for realistic SGC angle, 30 to 45 degree. This angle is about 30 degree. In this case, after proper elevation, dehiscence was observed in buffer side. Vertical incision was performed only distal in canine for minimizing scar formation, not vertical incision, only canine distal. Implant, narrow cross fit, bone level tapered stroma implant, 3.3 mm by 12 mm was placed in ideal position with digital drill surgical guide. Dehiscence of bone. This portion. Implant depth is 3.5 mm. Gingival line to implant shoulder, 3.5 mm. Please check 3.5 mm. Gingival line for future and to implant shoulder. And extracted tooth was transformed to bone substitute material. We call this bone is old tooth bone. This old tooth bone was grafted to buffer dehiscence for contour augmentation. This tooth to old tooth bone. Buffer dehiscence was covered with old tooth bone. Over 2 mm buffer bone is necessary. Over 2 mm. Enough releasing incision was necessary for covering augmented bone. Releasing incision is necessary. If you are interested in releasing incision, please access ITI Online Academy about releasing incision. I posted releasing incision video.
This case demonstrates the scissor technique for releasing the periosteal. Performing the pseudo-periosteal flaps and raise with vertical releasing incisions adjacent to right central incisor and left lateral incisor. The flap is extended apically beyond the microtrigeminal junction. A light still contraction suture to the use of the tendon fracture of the parietal flap. Traction suture and fine tissue forceps, the flap is gently buckling, providing clear visibility in the undersurface of the flap and the periosteum. The periosteum. periosteal releasing incision is made by fine overlapping cuts of periosteum with a pair of dissecting scissors. The surgeon commences the incision on the right side and extends it easily across the midline to the left side. With this technique, very fine control of the incision can be achieved, as the surgeon can feel the any adhesions within the tissues as the cuts are being made. It's important to combine each incision to create a single horizontal incision in the periosteum. It's also important to check that the horizontal incision meets the base of the vertical incision on both sides. Here the surgeon is confirming this and making additional cuts where necessary. At this point, after creating a clear view of the periosteum, the surgeon checks the horizontal incision to see if there are any adhesions or muscle attachments without preventing the flap from being released. Additional fine cuts are made where these adhesions are detected. The bubble frame is then pulled gently towards the palatal side. This then confirms that there is enough mobility in the flap to cover the planned bone growth after the implant placement and to achieve primary wound closure. This is the clinical appearance immediately after wound closure following surgery. 3 days after surgery, normal healing continues. Post-operative healing remains uneventful through the eighth day. This is the clinical image 15 days post-operatively following surgery.
You can see after suturing, a good releasing incision resulted in good adaptation of flap. And 2 weeks later, after implant placement, you can see good healing of soft tissue. And in this case, do you see, can I take laser impression, cutting surface or scanning post is implant shoulder 5 mm. So if between mucosal margin and implant shoulder is over 5 mm, impression is impacted. In this case, we can take impression, the opening for detecting cutting surface. This is cutting surface. Implant shoulder to margin to 3.5 mm. And roll technique was applied for upper contour augmentation. You can see treatment sequence of implant treatment in periarterial radiograph. Please see the procedure of computer designing and provision restoration. Tissue arrangement and contour adjustment. He is my technician. He designed this. After my lecture, he had a lecture on this case. And ideal to figure. ideal marginally. And present the situation was set, this crown was fabricated considering an XTC angle is 30 degree and ideal visible margin. And please note buckle pressure to buckle contour improvement. This screw height is 3.5 millimeters.